Welcome friends, it's such a joy to be together with you, and this week we want to look at some ingredients for success. And the first ingredient that I want to talk about is passion. Passion is so important when we are engaged in any form of work. Now, it could have to do with our careers, but it could also have to do with our daily mundane tasks. But passion is a key ingredient. Here's a scripture for us. It says, "Whatever your hand finds to do, do it with your might. For there is no work or device or knowledge or wisdom in the grave where you are going." So, you know, here we see that we're called to do the things that are given to us passionately. Do it, you know, with our whole hearts. In fact, the Message translation, where it says, "Do it with your might," the Message translation says, "Grab it and do it, and do it heartily." So we're supposed to grab it be very passionate about the work that we are doing. Now, it is possible that as we start working on something, initially we're very encouraged, but things become rather routine, and then we lose that excitement or that passion. But it's important to somehow maintain that passion, because it will keep us fired up, and it will help us to go to the end of the task and also to deliver the most. So passion is extremely important. Now, if at all we come to a place in our journey, in that assignment, where we've lost the interest of doing that particular task, then, you know, it's good to search and evaluate, you know, what exactly is causing us to lose our excitement, because it won't help for us to just drag our feet on that project or the assignment. We need our passion back. Now, here is an example from Nehemiah and his team building the wall in Nehemiah chapter 2, verses 17 through 18, where he invites the people to come and build together. And I'm going to read that passage for us. He says, "Then I said to them, 'You see the distress that we are in, how Jerusalem lies waste and its gates are burned with fire. Come, let us build the wall of Jerusalem, that we may no longer be a reproach.' And I told them of the hand of my God, which had been good upon me, and also of the king's words that he had spoken to me. So they said, 'Let us rise up and build.' Then they set their hands to their good work." You know, a team that was losing focus, a team that had lost energy. You know, Nehemiah builds up their energy once again. How does he do it? And we can take lessons from here. He shows them the big picture, that they are building the wall together. And in the same way, whatever task we're engaged in, if we can look at the big picture and see how we're contributing to a great cause, that will keep us motivated. And here we also see that Nehemiah is focusing more on the why. And the why is always important. Why are we doing what we're doing? And that will help us, you know, keep moving on in the journey. And we also see here that he talks about the positives, that God's hand is upon him. And I'm sure, you know, there are challenges in every task, but if we focus on the positives, it gives us that much more energy to keep working hard. So don't lose your passion, get fired up, remain motivated, and keep moving forward. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your grace upon our lives, and God, for every opportunity that you've given us. Lord, we pray that you will help us stay motivated, oh God, to see the big picture and keep, Lord, doing the work heartily, Lord, that you've given us. We thank you once again. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.